Hello everyone, I am Mukesh Kumar Thakur and I am from India. I have done my bachelor and master from India and then I moved to Taiwan to pursue my PhD and I have finished my PhD from National Yang Ming University, Taipei, Taiwan in the year of 2020. After that, I joined as a postdoctoral fellow in Dr. Kalvaj group in Czech Republic and currently I am working on graphene fossilization. So fossilize the graphene to have the like semiconducting property in the graphene. And basically what I do, my main research focused on fossilization of graphene. So graphene is a 2D materials and which has a very fascinating property compared to all any other material which is exist till now. But the one major drawback with this graphene, it is band gap. So graphene doesn't have any band gap and due to this we cannot make any transistor. And so this is the major drawback we have here in the graphene research. So researchers trying from last decades to have a band gap, and so like many reports they claim the graphene is a tunable band gap and that can be made by graphene fossilization. So in fossilization basically we can do hydrogenation of graphene, chlorination and fluorination, but compared to all three the fluorination is the best way to have the tunable band gap in graphene. So one major drawback with again the fluorination, once you do the fluorination you lose the intrinsic property of graphene, for example mobility and the drain current. So again we came with the conventional semiconductor which has similar mobility with the fluorographene. So that is like is our main focus, like how to improve the mobility as well as keeping the graphene pristine property and have some band gap also. So as I talked about the fluorographene, so basically, so for example if you can see, so this is like a prototype of graphene. So you have graphene. So in recent study what we have done, so take this graphene, do the fluorination, so fluorine atom will come and it will attach on the graphene surface and it makes a carbon fluorine bond. So but as I mentioned, like the fluorine is not stable on the graphene surface, so our idea is like let's put another layer of graphene on the top of this, and in such a way so we have the three region. One is the fluorinated graphene, another is the sandwich, is a heterostructure, and third is the pristine graphene. And also the one good thing in our lab, we have the isotropically labeled graphene. So all the graphene has different Raman modes, and then we study the Raman spectroscopy and other property by this all three region in the fluorographene, heterostructure and the pristine graphene. And what we found that at the heterostructure, this fluorographene and pristine graphene both has a electrostatic interaction and which stabilize the fluorine on the graphene surface. Now the question is how to produce this fluorinated graphene. So in our case what we have done, first we have grow the graphene on copper foil using the standard chemical vapor deposition method, and you can see here is we have a large area graphene. Then we transfer this graphene on silicon silica substrate, and you can see here, so we have graphene on the large scale on silicon silica substrate. And after that we have put this silicon silica substrate graphene on xenon difluoride exposure. So we have a homemade setup where we do the fluorination, and after that we have this fluorographene on the silicon silica substrate. As I talked about the CVD graphene, and in the CVD graphene like we use so many polymers to transfer the graphene on the silicon silica. To avoid the polymer and other issue, we have also studied the same thing with the exfoliated sample. In the exfoliated sample, like you don't have any polymer and other issue. And here you can see the how we prepare the sandwich structure. So this is the, here is the one layer, then this is the sandwich, and this is the another like the pristine graphene layer. So in the same devices, we have three layer. In the conclusion remarks, so in our recent work, so we have found a way to have a stable fluorographene in graphene system. So using this heterostructure, now we have fluorine stable in graphene, and also we have some kind of band gap which can help in the to have the transistor and other devices.